Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with My Villain Academia. Last time on My Villain Academia, we had Sad Man's Parade, a surprisingly uplifting episode, actually, where Twice overcame his trauma, figured out that he is indeed the original version of him, and created the Sad Man's Parade of infinite doubles to attack the Meta Liberation Army. He also got some of his doubles up to the tower to face Redestro, and we got a bit of Redestro's quirk, some sort of gigantification of some sort. I said that twice. Doesn't matter. Anyway, he was just about to beat the clone of Shigaraki when the real Shigaraki showed up and brought down the tower. So yeah, it's time for our kind of hyped up fight of Shigaraki versus Redestro. So yeah, I think that this is going to be a nice, fun, happy episode. It's not going to be fun and happy, is it? That's okay. Maybe it'll have a good fight? I don't know. I hope it's a decent fight. I really like when Shigaraki fights, you know? Like, there's something about it. I mean, he's very agile. He has to be. And just the fact that it's all he needs is just the touch, you know? That's all he needs, so I don't know. I'd be curious for a very legitimate fight between Shigaraki and Redestro. So let's see if that's what's going to be in this episode. Like always, the reaction is down in the description and in the pinned comment for your viewing pleasure. So let's go ahead and jump right into this episode of My Villain Academia. Here we go.
I'm sad now.
This poor fucking family. It's imagine if he manifested a different power. And he was age 5. That's pretty late in the game to be manifesting a quirk. Imagine if he got something else. What would have happened? It's the 1-2 punch, isn't it? It's that the Shimura family sucked, and also that Tenko gained the power of decay. It's definitely a 1-2 punch. That is the most graphic his decay has ever been, you know? I mean, I guess we should have known that this was gonna be some sad shit, but that's some sad shit right there. And again, the fact that this all stems from Nana Shimura, like, one of the happiest anime girls I've ever seen. You know, she literally, she created, she created the philosophy of smiling. Heroes smiling. Oh, and when it come back to those pictures of her and baby Kotaro, that is the cutest friggin' thing. But one thing led to another. One thing led to another. You know, last episode when I said, oh, I can't wait to get to the next episode, I'm excited. I'm sure you all were like, oh, buddy. That's why they gave us last episode. That's definitely why they gave us last episode with Twice overcoming his trauma and things getting a little inspiring, is because they were about to gut punch us with this. I feel more gut punched than Class 1A did against Mirio. Christ almighty, can we go back to the heroes? This is where we're catching up, by the way, on My Hero Academia. This is where we're going to have to leave it for a while. Now, yes, we have 2 more episodes of the season, but this is where we're going to leave it for a little while until Season 6 starts up. This. The tragedy of Tenko Shimura. Notes. And you know what, here. Because I have this right here. This is the shot glass I use in Attack on Titan. It's my specific fat man nuclear bomb. Goes with the Colossal Titan. But this is what I take a shot from this when characters die on Attack on Titan. And this is how I'm going to drink my Pepsi for the remainder of this episode. And yes, I am drinking a Pepsi. It's non-alcoholic. But if there was any episode that made you want a stiff drink, it was this. Oh. This seems kind of weird, but I was going to look up who voices Kotaro Shimura. I was going to look up who voices Kotaro because his voice sounds familiar. Man, the black hair in this family. Can I just say that real quick, by the way? The black hair that runs in this family is interesting, you know? Like, I don't know why that's interesting, but it is. And now we finally have an answer to why Shigaraki's hair is different. It turned with his quirk. Kotaro Shimura, Kotaro Jujo, voice actor. Alright, friend, my anime list, update your stuff. Okay, My Hero Academia Wiki. I don't think I'm gonna, okay. Aaron Campbell. I feel like I've heard that name before. What? Hold on, this looked up Aaron. Hold on, voice actor. Okay, if you type in just Aaron Campbell to Google, it's gonna get you some weird stuff. Okay, anime voice actor wiki. He played Carlo on Attack on Titan. I don't remember who Carlo was. Not important. Though I'm sure he did a good job. No? Okay, I don't recognize his voice from anything. Well, it was a good voice. It sounded... I mean, that's a thing. A lot of times, I find that it's a 40% chance I actually recognize a voice actor. But yeah. If I knew who the hell... Okay, you only have... Attack on Titan Carlo. Who the hell is Carlo? Oh, he was in the Panzer unit. Oh, okay. I still don't recognize the voice, but... Yeah, alright. I'm just gonna set this back down. Try to find the happiness, folks. Try to find the happiness. If four seasons of Mr. Robot has taught me anything, it's to find the happiness in whatever you're watching. Well, the present day stuff is fun. Yeah. The present day stuff is fun, at least. So, first off, I like this idea that to change or to make a double of Toga and then use that to give the original a blood transfusion. That's very clever, actually. it is also funny though. So, what did he say it was since the last time? I don't remember when. I think it was for the Yakuza. Oh, excuse me, jeez. I think it was for the Yakuza where... but basically, Twice says, like, oh, your measurements are all different now. Dang puberty. It's like, yeah, she's... I guess, I don't know, she's growing up. She's becoming a woman, I suppose. So that's actually a funny detail that... Because she seems to be the youngest of... the She seems to be the youngest of our sort of core group of the League of Villains. So, yeah, she's still a growing girl. A growing teenage girl. So that's kind of funny. Is this hand dusty? Oh my gosh. My hand is dusty. I wonder whose hand this is. Also, you know, I guess his power has gotten stronger. His power must have gotten stronger to where he completely incinerates something, because that was a lot of blood and guts going on there, you know? That was a lot of blood and guts going on there. But now I understand how, these are the hands of your family. Yeah, I getcha. Anyway, yeah, Toga, double, that was clever. We had the politician, Trumpet, with his power Incite. It's exactly what I thought it would be. He can incite people and make them stronger. It's slightly like LaBrava's love quirk, where it empowers someone else, but obviously completely different method of doing that. Although it is based on speech, though, because he incites people through his words, and LaBrava had to confess to Gentle. Remember Gentle? Those were the days. Remember when I said Gentle was the only tragic villain we've had? Jesus Christ. I guess everyone in the League of Villains has a tragedy, you know? Stain wasn't that tragic. He just sort of became a villain. And then, Overhaul wasn't really tragic, you know? But pretty much everyone in the League, now they are tragic villains. So, and speaking of people who are not tragic villains, Redestro's not tragic. He's just like, oh, he's just doing what he does, you know? He doesn't have a tragic origin. We also had a bit with Spinner, and his backstory, how he's unmotivated. I like how he says, you know, he's a follower, and that started with Stain, and I like how that is now on Shigaraki, you know? Because for a while we've had that where it's like, oh, well, you know, Shigaraki, he's using, you know, Stain's ideologies to his advantage, but no, it does seem like genuinely Spinner believes in Shigaraki, which I like. Again, I really like this family. Shigaraki traded one family for another, apparently. I don't know why I turned into a leprechaun to say that, but anyway. Now, you guys told me that in the manga, there's, like, part of a story arc that's, like, cut. Or at least before the Gigantomachia stuff, where the League of Villains, like, faces this other group or something. But they've just completely cut that from the anime. So, you guys have recommended that I actually read through this arc in the manga, because they did cut out a lot. So, yeah, definitely after the season, I would definitely be interested in doing that, and then doing a basically just a recap video of this arc in the manga before we get into season 6. So, I'll definitely be doing that, but we'll go ahead and wait for the season to end. So yeah. But yeah, that was interesting with Spinner. And then we did get... We got a bit of the hype of Shigaraki versus Redestro. His quirk is stress, which is interesting, or his meta ability, because they want to be pretentious. I guess that's sort of it, is that these are pretentious villains, whereas Shigaraki is not pretentious. Like, no, he's fucking tragic. Yeah, these are fake. These villains are like fake gamer girls. Like, they're not real. Yeah, they're not real villains like Shigaraki. I'm trying to mask how fucking sad that shit is, but we're gonna have to get into it in a minute. But anyway, but Redestro's quirk was very interesting. The whole thing of stress, that he can store all of his stress and use it to empower himself. That was very, very interesting. And the fact that he can actually like concentrate that into this like a Kamehameha basically, and then attack with it, which was pretty crazy. But Shigaraki tanked it. I gotta say, you know, when we started off, it's amazing to see how far we've come in 111 episodes, where we start off in season one with Shigaraki. He's just some punk, basically, you know? He's some punk with his gamer analogies trying to destroy All Might with his Nomu, you know? And then now to see him, like, he is a force to be reckoned with that decay. He's strong, he's fast, and his quirk is powerful, you know? It's crazy. So, yeah, that, oh my gosh. So, that was crazy. And yeah, he's just too fast. And also, he did only use two fingers to activate his quirk, which is crazy. So he's leveling up, definitely. Which we had a bit of that a little while ago with he decayed that entire group of people just instantly. So yeah, Shigaraki has definitely gotten so much stronger. And yeah, all that training with Gigantomachia, I mean, a month and a half of just fighting Gigantomachia, the boys leveled up. It's crazy. And then, backstory. So, the gist of this is that Kotaro Shimura, again, this is where, you know, I wish that, I do hope that the theory of Inko Midoriya being Nanashimura's daughter is true, just so this family isn't that fucking tragic, but I think it is, you know? I think it is. I think it's just where we're going with that. But anyway, so Kotaro Shimura hates his mother for abandoning him, and anytime there's any talk of heroes, he takes it out. And that's interesting, the whole, the itching thing. They thought it was allergies. I guess it's just the beginning of his quirk, you know? The beginning of the decay quirk. And so, yeah, he punishes Tenko for... punishes Tenko for talking about heroes. And then one day, Hana, his older sister, finds, and we don't know what the hell her quirk was, or his quirk, we don't know any of their quirks aside from Tenko, finds a picture of Kotaro, baby Kotaro and Nanashimura, and that sets him off. He slaps Tenko, puts him outside, and then... I like at least that he realized that he went too far, and that his wife was putting her foot down on that shit. So there was that at least, you know, perhaps this could have gone, I mean, the only reason this went downhill again was because of the quirk that Tenko manifested, you know? So yeah, he was going to do that. Also, Hana sold him out. Hana sold him out, but she went to apologize, realized the dog died, then she died, then the family died, and then Kotaro died, and he fucking... You know, if he killed the others, he murdered his father. So there's that. Ugh, this fucking... Oh my god, we're already on 47 minutes on this recording? Jesus Christ. Okay, so that's tragic, and then after that, he finds, or All for One finds him, and then he is reborn as Tomura Shigaraki. Okay. I mean... is so sad. You know, it's... Alexa, play Despacito. It's so sad. Here's a question. Does decay not work on him? Is he the only thing he can't decay? Maybe, because he was, like, scratching himself. If he puts all five on himself, you would think it would kill him, but maybe he's immune to his own quirk. I could see that. I could see that happening. And yeah, no one helped him. No one's come for you, have they?
and I mean Kotaro, that, I mean, being abandoned by his mother, like, I mean, that had to have been traumatizing. And you have to also remember that just before his mother put him into foster care or wherever, you know, gave him away, his father died. You have to remember that too, because they said that Shimura's husband was killed. And because Shimura's husband was killed, she put him in foster care. So that had to have been traumatizing. The boy lost his father, and then his mother gave him away. All of that then stays with him for years. Grows into this deep resentment for heroes. And that then comes out on his son. That is so sad.
I'm sorry I have to leave suddenly, but your mom has to go fight a really bad man right now.
She had to leave him to fight All for One.
The whole time. I'd never forgive myself if this bad man did something mean to you. That's why we can't be together anymore, Kotaro. I'm sorry I wasn't a better mother to you. Honestly, I am. You might end up hating me, but know this. No matter what happens in the future, I love you, my son. I hope your life is full of laughter and that you'll be happy. Always smiling. I'll be watching over you. Promise. Even if it's from above.
It would have been better if you never loved me.
No more of this.
I mean, if she hadn't, it would have happened anyway. He would have been put into foster care anyway, probably, since, yeah, she went away to fight All for One, and she died doing that. You know, I come here for a good time. Fucking hell. It's so fucking sad. It's just one thing leading to another, and they look like they had so much fun in the past, you know? But that, I mean, it's a 1-2 punch for Kotaro. His father is murdered and his mother abandons him. Yeah. No shit, he was traumatized. And then he tried getting better, but all those years later, all of that is then put onto his son, Tenko. It really, see, this is the strange thing. It's so weird that it's like happenstance of what quirk Shigaraki gained, you know? Because it was decay. Now, they say he 5 years old and no quirk yet. So they probably thought he was going to be quirkless. But all that scratching probably was an indication of his quirk. It didn't fully happen. He had it. It just wasn't fully accessible yet. Not until that moment. You
It does make you think, though, with everything that happened with this family, you almost wonder if there's a little foul play involved. You almost wonder, because if not, it's the largest of coincidences that this happened, you know? That all of that boiled over, and then that was just like, for that to be perfectly given to All For One on a silver platter to create Tomura Shigaraki.
Okay, so yeah, so he kills the dog, killed his sister, killed his mother, killed his grandparents, and then absolutely murdered his father. And that's the origin. Tenko Shimura origin. It's... I'm glad there was other shit in this episode. Gigantomachia is coming! He's about to fuck up Redestro. Toga and Twice and Dobby and Spinner and Mr. Compress. Even Shigaraki is like, I love seeing the boy getting good and stuff. It's like, I have to like divorce this from Shigaraki. But you obviously can't, you know? It's like, I don't want to think about this tragic stuff. I want to think about Shigaraki going in and kicking some guy's ass, you know? I'm a simple man. It's been a fucking downer half of the season. Jesus Christ. With all the Endeavor shit and now this shit is a downer. God damn it. I should have saved the movie for after. God damn it, what was I thinking? I should have saved Heroes Rising for after this season so that I would end on a happy note. It's so sad. Alexa, play Despacito. I apologize if I am activating anyone's Alexa right now. There's nothing else to say. It's just tragic. I'm sad. It's sad. I'm slightly apathetic about it. Like, I'm not letting myself go or anything. Like, I could probably freaking cry at this. Like, this is sad as hell. But it's like, I feel like I'm trying to suppress this. Basically, I'm trying to make sure this doesn't ruin my day. You know? Trying to make sure this doesn't ruin my day. I want to have a good day. I want to... You know, when I get done with these episodes, I want to be like, okay, yes, we had an emotional time, but I want to, now it's time to move on until the next episode. And I'm going to try to do that by, I'm going to go eat some lunch and I'm not going to focus on this. I'll think about something else. Let's think about what if Tenko Shimura didn't gain the power of decay? What if Shimura was still alive? We'll think about that. We'll think about a happy thing. We'll think about that poor, beautiful woman sacrificing herself against All For One. It really is that because I immediately formed an attachment because she's cute. God damn it. I want to go back to Class 1A. I want to see Eri. I want to see Mirio. I want to see Yayorozu. I want to see everyone. I want to see Aizawa. I want to see everyone else. I want to see this sad shit anymore. I'll be alright. I'll be alright. It's fine. It's good. It's brilliant. That's the thing. It's just... It's this depressing stuff, man. It gets to me. Like, it gets to all of you. I'm delaying the ending of this episode. I don't know if I'm ever going to look at these hands the same way again. But... Yeah. And with all that being said, I'm Alex from Seventh Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching me be sad about an episode of My Villain Academia. If you want to watch more episodes, there is a playlist as well as another video, which is probably something happier that you can go click on. There's also a subscribe button and a Patreon button to see where the next episode will lead us down this sad, sad path. There's also other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys later.